Outside Detroit, retired real estate agent Nancy has allowed decades of uncontrolled shopping to fill her lakeside home with clutter.
It's absolute chaos. The moment you open the door.
Okay, so there's the living room, dining room where it's horrifying, I'd say. I'm kind of into little bits of everything, like Oriental, you know, and anyways.
I just looked at my mom as someone who loved to shop, you know.
Just kept getting more and more accumulated. When it first happens, you don't notice it as much until it gets to be to the point where it's like a mountain instead of a molehill. Oh, gosh. This is a box I was going to put actually my, you know, seeds, the bigger ones with the, you know, I got a whole bag of seeds in there and just to store it and just label that or whatever. So I save everything because, you know, waste not, want not, you know what I mean? It's the guilt, the shame, the embarrassment of being so out of control and not wanting people to see that.
But Nancy must now put all those emotions aside. Her husband, Tom, who suffers from dementia, has been staying in assisted living until Nancy cleans her home. In need of help, Nancy has agreed to let her best friend, Norma, inside for the first time in 3 years.
I talk to Nancy just about every day, and every day I hear, I need help. I don't know where to start. I'm paralyzed. And then with Tom getting sick, then Nancy really, really felt something has to be done. Nance!
Yeah, come on.
Oh, my God. Oh, Nancy. Oh, my gosh. Nancy, where are you?
No, it's okay. You know what I mean?
Oh, Nancy, this is terrible.
Norm, don't.
This is terrible.
Don't dramatize. It's,
My first reaction was, oh, my God. This was uninhabitable. I mean, it was much, much more serious than I ever anticipated.
Oh, Nancy.
Stop, okay.
I can't stop. It looks to me like you just took boxes of stuff and dumped it out. I thought I would be able to help you.
I know. And I know everybody.
I'm paralyzed now. Oh, gosh, Nance.
It wasn't meant to be like this. I know
it wasn't. You had a beautiful home.
What happened to Nancy? Where did Nancy go? I mean, how have I missed this? I talked to her a couple days a week. I mean, so how could she get this far in and keep it practically hidden? If you didn't see it, you wouldn't believe it.
It got so out of control when Tom's dementia was getting worse.
He can't come back until this is done.
Now, Tom's health, we don't know why people get what they get, but I'm sure his living situation certainly did not help it.
My God, this is overwhelming. Oh, I can't even look in there. You know what, Nancy? This would cause me to have a breakdown. A nervous breakdown. That's what this would do.
I know the way, and I'm gonna do what I should have done and reach for help to get me there.
What we're gonna do is
Janet Kester heads up the physical efforts, while clinical psychologist Dr. Becky Beaton keeps a close eye on Nancy's emotional state.
Everybody, I'm Dr. Becky. I'm a psychologist, and I really wanna let you know that this is Nancy's home, and she is in charge. And she gets to decide, has the final decision on everything. Okay, you guys ready to get going?
We're ready.
All right, let's go.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Let's go.
Sun is shining.
Let's just start off with a half a dozen boxes, maybe a bubble.
Wow, we've got a landslide coming.
Cards could go with paperwork.
But after an enthusiastic start, it isn't long before Nancy's mood takes an unexpected turn.
These are all cookbooks. I just put them here, for God's sake.
They look pretty organized. Do you want to keep cookbooks? You can keep cookbooks.
Yes.
Yes, it's okay.
I'm not doing anything. As far as cookbooks, the great thing about cookbooks now.
I know. Mom, you don't get the pictures, Jay, okay?
No, you can just get
them online. Some ones I want
us to keep. Does
she have a way of getting online?
This goes for outside. Can I have a chance to say something for myself? Holy cow, that hangs up above the thing over there.
Do you want us to stop? We can stop right now.
Yes, for a second, please. Here, you can take that to the shop. I don't give a about some other stuff, but
Hey, take a deep breath. We can stop it. Right away this morning, Nancy got really upset. It was very overwhelming for her, and she wanted to see everything, touch everything, and make a decision about it.
Oh, God.
She was not good with giving other people the ability to make decisions for her.
Never mind. Oh, God. Forget it. I'll take a break right now, because, certain things I got to keep. It was like you couldn't breathe. It was like a person restrained and not knowing how to get out of the restraints. What, this is closed, Nancy.
I thought I could make a decision on something, okay?
You're making it on everything that's important. We're picking up trash and dirty papers.
That's not trash over
there. There's a lot of trash. Hey, do you think this is not trash?
Okay.
This is trash, Nancy.
We do not want to traumatize Nancy, and if this is going to traumatize her, it's not going to do any good. She's just going to go ahead and collect more items and bring them into the home.
Okay, Nora, wait a
second. Everybody stop for a second. Stop asking her questions. She needs to go out. Come here, Nancy. This isn't good for your blood pressure. Up the stairs. Come on, sweetie. Up the stairs. Here we go.
And Nancy,
come on, up the stairs. Norma. Up the stairs.
I just got this at the Salvation Army.
She's just putting it aside to go on a tarp.
Stop it for a minute, please. My tablecloths I use for outside tablecloths.
Wait.
I just want you to
They're going to throw it out.
We're not going to throw out nothing, man.
I thought I could look at them before you guys.
Come here. Take a breather. I just want you to take a breather, okay?